My father was a bar fight referee. Settling scores was a way of life. He owned a 1958 Gibson Flying V guitar. In his spare time, he was a rock star. His greatest hits were composed on my mother's body. There is something breathtaking about a punctured lung, how you break a woman's body like a midday fast and mold her into an invertebrate, an octopus who has no spine to stand up to a man. You see, women like my mother have mastered the art of hiding their scars long before this deceptive generation discovered Photoshop. So when you ask me in what language her sob sounded like, I'd say it sounded like a talking drum made out of stretched skin concealing things. I guess that's why they call it hide. My mother's tongue is not English or Yoruba or Isha. My mother's tongue is salivary, a trait that comes from swallowing so much of one's pride you forget how to spit it out, as if a Tallinn secrets amnesia. 25 years down the marriage, curtains drawn, looking through every window of opportunity only to admit that the future comes with a clenched fist, so no one knows what tomorrow holds. This language I speak has no room for promises. Isn't that why the alphabet can only keep 5 vowels? Isn't that why my father loved my mother with a consonanted love? It couldn't have been a coincidence that even grammar acknowledges the past tense of ring is wrong. Somebody needs to tell these men that a matrimonial home is not a vet clinic and women should not be treated like animals. How a woman ends up being the one who grabbed the mastic in a burning house eludes me. Suddenly, the fact that she was made from a broken rib becomes the bone of contention. You see, when my 10-year-old sister asks my mother what happiness means, she says, happiness is pointing a flashlight at the night sky, hoping it brightens up the world. The time is 9/11. My father comes home as high as the World Trade Center, his fists a flying Boeing. There are Talibans in our living room. How else can a heated argument start a fire? How else does the Pentagon look so much like my mother's face? You see, I don't know much about hijacked planes and Al-Qaeda missions, but I know by the night I stood up to the villain. Though when your father, mother and your son go to battle, we call it a nuclear war. I still remember how I cut him off with a kitchen knife and how mother had to finish the sentence. Sometimes, there is no silver lining to a mushroom cloud.